Grocery store, and I'm back, and Allie Jo is doing her math back there. I was getting ready to look at my calendar just to see what I have going on here. Okay, so here's my calendar. For today, I actually had this mistakenly over here. So Josh didn't get any of his schoolwork done before 10 because when he has a Lamerick call, he usually comes downstairs, gets all set up, makes sure he has all his stuff together for them to call. And when it was like 10 minutes after, I knew that something was right. So I looked it up and sure enough, it's on Tuesday. So we had the wrong day. Anyway, I'm doing laundry right now because laundry is on Monday. And Allie Jo is doing schoolwork. Josh is upstairs doing schoolwork. I was going to show you how I do. I used to use my Erin Condren teacher planner to keep track of all their lesson plans. And because they're at an age now where I don't really have to write a lot of lesson plans in as far as like me teaching them. Now it's really just me writing what lesson they're supposed to have done down. And I just started thinking, why am I taking the time to write down every lesson when that's all I'm writing down is like what lesson it is for them to do that day? It just seemed kind of silly. So what I did is I went to this method, which, so now what I do is I just print out the table of contents and for like the whole curriculum. And so here was the first day. Here was the first section. Oh, that's really weird. It looks pink, but it's yellow. That's so weird. This is actually yellow highlighter, but it's coming up pink on my camera. Anyway. So we just start out the beginning of the year with lesson one, and when she does a lesson, she just marks it out. And then as I get further into the year, what I do is I start to do the numbers, like how many we have left. Like I'll just write next to it what it is so that now I know that for the year, she has 43 math lessons left to get to the end of the year. And so then I can kind of keep check on the calendar to make sure that she is, you know, going at a good pace to get finished before testing. So I do that for all of them. There's Josh's. That's Josh's history. This must be Josh's math. Here, let me see. Yes, this is Josh's. Is this Josh's math? Yes, Josh's math. So Josh only has, well, he had 40 lessons left, which is really, about 10 weeks of school left, but I know he's done more than this. He just hasn't reported back to me to mark them off. And then I've got Allie Jo's science here. This is her grammar. This is her history. And Josh's CLEP requirements for the classes that he's going to CLEP out of this year. And I just keep track of them that way. So that works out easier for me. I know that it's probably, let me turn this around. I know that it's probably easier when they're younger to actually have a lesson planner, because you're writing down a lot of things that you're going to be doing. Like, you know, you have to write out your lesson plans and what your plan is for the day, like what you're planning on doing. But once they get my kids' age, it's really just about like, okay, do lesson 50 in math and do lesson 52 in history. So, and they know what they have to get done and they do it. And then I just grade the work. So it's not really so much about me teaching anymore as much as it is them keeping up with what they have to get done. So I switched to this method, and so far it's working. So anyway, say hi, Chino. You say hi? Say good morning. So anyway, we'll get back to work. We'll see you in a bit. Hey, Chino, want to go for a walk? Yeah? Okay, let me go get my coat, okay? Let's go get my coat. Are we going for a walk, Chino? Okay, go. Gotta let Allie go past, okay?
Oh my gosh, this is scary. This is scary. I hate going down this road.
You're good.
No, I am not good. What if I fall off? I'm so scared.
Oh my gosh,
I'm
Allie.
I'm so scared it's gonna like go into the lake.
You're gonna be fine.
I'll wait until I get past.
Oh. You got it. Good job. Chino, you're pulling. Come on, buddy. Chino, you're pulling. Yeah. Oh. So, it's absolutely beautiful out today. I'm so excited to be going for a walk. After all the cold weather, it feels really good to be out here. Allie Jo's having fun on her ripstick. We'll call this recess. Chino, are you happy to be outside? Yeah.
Oh, that was
fun. Oh, potty break. Okay, so we made it back from the potty break. I absolutely love this sunshine. It feels so good to be outside. And the lake is really pretty. There's some duckies back there.
Tito is already tired.
Well, he's not used to walking. I know I've said a few times about Chino's surgery, but he's actually 6 weeks post-op tomorrow. And so he is pretty much back to normal. Like, if any of you ever have to have knee surgery on your dogs, the first 2 weeks are really rough. But after that 2 weeks, things pretty much calm down and they get better very quickly. So he is pretty much back to normal. Besides the fact that he's just a little out of shape now. He's not used to going for walks or anything. We hadn't been going for walks. He wasn't allowed until about 4 weeks. And then we had to ease into it. So now when we go for walks, he's panting and he's pretty tired right now. But thank you. No.
He's hugging so hard.
I know.
But he's so cute. You can't resist it because he's just like so excited. When we went on a walk, he was just like, he just kept like not tugging him hard, just like every once in a while doing that. And he eventually just came in the middle of us. It was so cute. Which direction are we going?
I think
we should go to the left. And go up that way and down the path and then come back down.
I'm gonna get you going down this hill.
No.
What?
No, I am not going down this.
Why not?
Remember that time that I, like when I, the day that I got my ripstick, Daddy was like, go down this hill, you're doing so well. I believe in you, I think you can do it. So I was like, okay. So I went down it and then I was like riding super, super fast and I was like, this is not gonna end well. So then I got to about here, and I was like, I'm about to fall off, but I don't want to smash my head into the rocks, So I waited a little bit, and then I went up this ramp, and it tripped my ripstick, and I fell off from there.
You can't really see it, but yeah there's like a little bump. Yeah, these little bumps here. Yeah.
At least I did do something that I haven't ever done before. I went across this bridge. The bridge over there.
You know what? I bet if you started right here, you'd be fine.
No.
Why not?
It's too steep. See how?
Well, honey, this was like a year ago. Like, you're much better now. No. Try it. No? Oh, my. No, you silly goose.
Maybe I'll start right here.
Okay, go ahead.
Wouldn't that be scary? This is my favorite. I only have two.
Yeah.
This one I got for Josh, but I liked it better, and he never rode it, so now it's mine. Oh, I'm scared. Okay.
So pretty. So we've turned around now and we're heading back, and I would have liked to have walked a lot further, but we have to be careful how much we walk Gino per day right now because he's still getting back into shape and his muscles get sore really quick. The other day I took him for a walk and I went a little further than I should have and he was kind of limping on that leg. So I just want to make sure that I don't, you know. His surgery was not cheap. It was expensive. So I just want to make sure that we don't do anything to sabotage that. I'd hate to have surgery again. And not just for the money, but because it's hard on him. So we'll head back home and we'll do this again tomorrow. So we're supposed to have a couple of really pretty days. So anyway, and there goes Sal down the hill. Oh, she jumped off.
It went too fast.
Oh, stop. Is there no way to slow it down?
No. It's just wheels. You just ride until your heart's content. Mine will never be.
So you're just gonna keep jumping off as you go down this hill?
Well, I don't wanna go too fast.
Oh my goodness.
That's too fast. I can't do this.
Girl and her dog.
Let's go that fast. Okay, I'm gonna carry it until I get to that.
Okay.
Because I'm lame.
So what do you have left to do today when we get home?
I have history and science.
History and science.
And maybe a health lesson.
And grammar.
And grammar. I guess.
I think we should do grammar first.
I think we should just skip grammar.
No!
For the whole year.
I don't think so.
Okay, I'm gonna start here.
Alright.
Everybody on the video is probably like, okay, you're boring us, just go. I'm like, I'm sorry. I know I'm lame.
There she goes.
It's too fast. I'm sorry, I started too early. I got anxious.
Okay. This is it. This is it. Everybody's wanting something exciting to watch. And there she goes. You did it good though.
Okay. So, Lauren and I like this trick. I don't know if I can do it with this one. I think it's my other one that I do it with. Yeah, it's my other one. This one doesn't have the little middle part.
Alright.
It's the smaller version. Inside.
This is how we do history.
And this is how we do an after walk relaxation. Yeah.
Chino, are you tired from the walk, buddy?
He was like laying next to his bed, and then I picked up his bed and moved it to the sunshine. And like right when he saw his bed go up, he just knew, and he like hopped up and ran into his, he like jumped up onto his bed and laid down.
Oh my goodness.
And he saw the thing over here, and he went to sleep.
He's cute. All right, I'm going to head upstairs and do what ironing is left and take care of the laundry.
Okay.
So you get your history lesson done.
Okay.
And when I get finished upstairs, I'll come down and then we'll do grammar.
If I have any laundry left, you can just put it in the basket that's in my bedroom.
Okay.
Because I still haven't put it away. I just got it yesterday. And yesterday was a little busy.
Yeah, that's true.
We have to, like, come home, change, go back out.
All right.
Oh, he's so cute.
I'm heading up.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye.
I'm going upstairs, buddy. I love you.
So I'm going to iron shirts now, and Allie Jo has decided to join me and read her history to me while I iron.
Oh,
chasing him around on the carpet. And then he was like running and he kept like stopping at the chair. And then I would see him stop and then I would keep chasing. And then eventually he just hopped up with Dad and he like laid down real fast and just stared at me. And now he's like, where is she?
Was that all you could take, Chino?
He was like, it was only like 3 laps.
That is so funny.
And then he like hopped up real fast and like was like, this is my base.
Is that what happened?
Puppy.
Who's the tired puppy, you or Chino?
A little bit of both.
Good question.
A little bit of both. Did you have a good day today?
I did have a good day today.
Yeah?
Yeah.
All right. Well, I think we're going to call it a day. The only thing I have left to do is clean the stove. And then we're going to just relax as a family, right?
Yep.
Right.
All right.
Sadly, we watched all, what's it called? The Netflix original?
It's really dark in here, guys.
Yeah,
what's the name of it?
Let me turn the light on.
We finished the series of unfortunate events. We finished the whole series. No, we didn't. It left it at like a really...
Oh, there we go.
...leading on thing. And it was really annoying because we're like, what's next? It's like, sorry, that's the last episode. It's like, you're killing me. You're killing me.
It was a pretty good show, though.
It was
Did
really
you like
good.
It?
I loved it.
Yeah. It was a little dark.
It was a little dark. The first couple episodes weren't as good, but then, like, once you get into, I'm not going to say his name, it starts to get really good.
Yeah.
I keep, like, looking up at my phone, and then I'm like, wait a minute, shouldn't I be looking at the camera?
So you highly recommend it, right?
Yes, it's a great show.
All right, well, I think we're going to wrap it up. You guys, do the two of you want to sign off for the night?
Good night,
Bye.
Everybody.
Thanks for watching. I'm Allie Jo.
Hey.
Thanks for watching. MiamiBuck.com.
Oh, my gosh.
Wrong channel.
Wow.
Oh, no.
All right, guys, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.